Hi, pretty people. Okay, so this morning I woke up to find on my, you know, the Time Hop app where it just tells you what, you know, all the social media stuff you posted, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years ago. Well, this morning on my 1 year ago, so for today, the 5th of March, but 2014, it had come up with that I posted that I received my letter from Killian Donnelly a year ago today, and I spoke about it in my last video briefly, and I was going to make a video about it, you know, when it happened, but that didn't end up happening. But I think it's just exciting that, you know, it's a year on and it's still exciting to me. So that's him there, where my finger is. He's just so insanely talented, I find, and I don't say that lightly. they actually downloaded the Memphis album from iTunes, and there was just some bits in it, particularly the song Memphis Lives in Me. I forget how good his voice was. So he's somebody that's inspired me for some time. So yeah, I sent him a letter, and just like, it was fairly lengthy. I don't even remember what was in it. And I also sent him like a photo of, you know, his panel to show you what I got. So at the top, you got Aaron Tveit, Fra Fee, George Blagden, and Killian Donnelly. And so I sent him his panel, and he actually, well, I sent him a picture while I was painting it, and he says, "That is amazing. Like, how did you do that?" And I thought it was pretty amazing that he was so, you know, he was so interested in that. So, you know, I thought when I wrote him a letter, I'd send him a picture of his panel. So, so anyway, 5th of March this came, and funnily enough, the London Post must be shocking, because this was written on the 10th of January 2014 and only came on the 5th of March. But I am going to read it out, and I'm actually really tempted to do it in an Irish accent. "Dear Tiana, thank you so much for the beautiful letter you wrote, and of course, the gorgeous paintings. I was very touched to receive such a gift, and your letter was a joy to read whilst waiting for a Thursday night show to start. Apologies, it's taken so long for me to reply. But a new musical requires a lot of attention, and luckily now I've more time. I'm glad you like my tweets. I'm a dork and proud. Also amazed that you like soul music. It's my absolute favorite, and the more I sing it, the more I love it. Also glad that you enjoyed the Les Mis film. Also glad that you enjoyed the Les Mis movie. That was such a fun experience, but also very tiring and demanding. It's not exactly a comedy, so there was a lot of tears on a daily basis. I hope you keep performing and singing, and who knows, perhaps one day we'll share the stage. You look beautiful in your paper, and I'll grow my hair back for you. Lots of love, Killian Donnelly." Sorry, there was so many mistakes in that. So, yeah, basically it says, "Dear Tiana, thank you so much for the beautiful letter you wrote, and, of course, the gorgeous paintings. I was very touched to receive such a gift. Also, your letter was a joy to read whilst waiting for a Thursday night show to start. Apologies it's taken so long for me to reply, but a new musical requires a lot of attention, and luckily now I have more time. I'm glad you like my tweets. I'm a dork and proud. Also amazed that you love soul music. It's my absolute favourite, and the more I sing it, the more I love it. Also glad you liked the Les Mis movie. That was such a fun experience, but also very tiring and demanding. It's not exactly a comedy, so there was a lot of tears on a daily basis. I hope you keep performing and singing, and who knows, perhaps one day we'll share the stage. You look beautiful in your paper, and I'll grow the hair back for you. Lot of love, Killian Donnelly. So funnily enough, I find that he did do as he promised. He is growing his hair up, because when he was talking about the Thursday night show star and the new musical, he just started in the commitments and he actually had to shave his head.
Yeah.
He had to, you know, shave his head for this role, but it's slowly growing out again. And yeah, I also sent him a few pictures from, you know, other shows that, like, other regional shows that I'd done. So, yeah, it's something special that, you know, means something to me, and it's actually kind of, it's a prized possession, because you don't get a lot of, you know, people that you're inspired by, you know, writing a letter to you. Usually just half the time they ignore it, so, or they get so much that they wouldn't even think to get it. So yeah, he was in the Les Mis film. He was in the stage show prior, actually. Before that, he was in... actually, no, that was his first show. And then he went to do Billy Elliot, which people know that I'm a massive Billy Elliot fan. And then he went on... He was Tony. So, first of all, in Les Mis, he started out as a swing, which he also did... he emergency covered both Valjean and Javert and did an insane job at it. So good. So he was a swing, so he played pretty much all the students. Then he went on to be Principal Ogera, and as always, amazing. So then he did the film. Oh, no, sorry, he did the 25th anniversary and he played Kufurak. Then he went on to play in the film, and he was Comfair. And if you have seen the film and wasn't sure who it was the guy in when Gavroche, you know, goes over the barricade just before he gets shot. Killian's the guy that's, like, you know, begging him to come back. So that was him. And then, so yeah, he went on to Billy Elliot, where he played Tony, the older brother, the quite abusive older brother. And I just watched the live DVD of Billy Elliot, and yes, Chris Grahamson was amazing, but I would love to have seen Killian in that role. So then he went on to play Ryle in Phantom of the Opera. Yeah, and then he was Deco in The Commitments. And now he's playing Huey in Memphis. So that's all the West End roles he's done and all the good stuff. So he's one of my inspirations, and I just don't have any more to say about how wonderful I think he, a wonderful person I think he is. He's done a few, you know, controversial things on Twitter. Some may even call it, you know, slightly sexist and stuff, but that's just something that happened in the past, and I'm sure many people have done it. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it there, and thank you for watching and listening to my ranting on. So yeah, I'll see you guys soon. Bye. Dear Tiana, thank you so much for the beautiful letter. Thank you so much for the beautiful It's not... It's not... Oh.